What's going on, guys? My name is Brandon Haneline, your Jeep informant, and today this video is for the more advanced Jeep enthusiasts. We're going to be going over wiring diagrams for the stop-start system and the auxiliary battery and all the components that are connected to that, and see, we're just going to kind of see how they're all tied in together. So we're going to be at the computer today, so let's go ahead and get started. All right, let's go ahead and pull this wiring diagram up, and I want to show you just several key things here. Right here is your intelligent battery sensor, which is the negative post of the large battery. Okay, and if you see right here, this auxiliary battery here, the auxiliary battery is the negative side is grounded onto the negative side of the large battery. So if you want to disconnect both power sources, you're going to have to disconnect this ground wire from the negative battery terminal and this, the actual negative battery terminal itself. Or if you want to, you can come over to the side of the fender well, and there's two grounds there. You can take those grounds off right there, which, you know, this is the grounds for the actual battery itself. So that would be the same as taking them off here. So either way, you won't, that actually disables, you know, the battery itself. So let's talk about the positive side of the battery. You got, you know, the large battery goes down here to the starter, and then it powers up this main power distribution center over here also. Now, over here you've got your alternator over here, okay, which or generator. Now, as you can see right here, look, this is for the 2 liter, okay? So the schematic that you're reading is for the 3.6 and 2 liter kind of, but this gives you just a little bit of information here of the 2 liter. We're not going to talk about that right now. That'll be in a totally different one. But as you can see here, let's zoom in just a little bit and take a look at this generator is producing, you know, we got a 300 amp fuse we got to go through, and that's going to power up. It's going to come over here, and it's going to charge. Actually, we're skipping over that, and we're going to charge the actual physical battery itself. There's your connection right there. Okay, as you can see right here, it actually, the alternator is not connected to the auxiliary battery, not at this point. Where it is going to be connected to is, if you take a look here, you see this, I'm going to scroll down here, you see this A right here, okay, this little A. What this is, I'm going to zoom back out and show you, there's another, let's see here. This A here and this A here is connected. Okay, so this comes up and just basically jumps over here and comes down. So when this relay power control is closed, okay, when this is closed, then and only then, if you zoom in from there, relay power control comes down. This is your 12 volts off your battery. When this is closed right here, this is energized, this is closed, then guess what, it comes up here, there's 150 amp fuse, and now it's tied into the alternator, it's tied into the charging system there. All right, I'm gonna zoom back out here. Let's take a look at several of the components that this whole system is going to. We got the body control module right here. Body control module, you know, is a very important part of this. This is what controls our stop-start. You know, it sees a bus signal from a lot of other components, and the body control module makes the decision to put the vehicle in a stop-start condition. So as you can see, the body control module here,
once everything is, once he's got all of his information, comes up here. And between the body control module and the powertrain control module, they energize these two relays and they operate the stop-start system. Now, there's a lot of inputs that go on here. So obviously the PCM is a very important part of this role. And here you go again. Here's another section of this 2 liter. So that does not apply to the 3.6. Now, if you see these dotted lines right here, okay, that is a connector. So, and you can see here's, right here's two sides of the connector, pin 6 on each side of that connector right there. All right, let's zoom back out a little bit. Here is your clutch switch interlock. That plays an important role too if we have the 6-speed manual. We got your wireless ignition node. That's just gonna, this is basically the startup saying, hey, you know, keys in ignition, I wanna be started. And it tells the RFH hub, with the radio frequency hub, that, hey, I got a message from the KIN, which is the K-I-N, which is keyless ignition node, that, hey, the vehicle wants to be started up. And then obviously the radio frequency hub talks to the body control module, then body control module to the PCM. So all this stuff plays a very, very important role. Here, let's see what's over here on this side. Integrated center stack switch. Okay, so all the this right here is your buttons on the dash. This would include your auto stop start button. If you wanted to disable it, it sends a message through the interior high speed bus system to the BCM saying, hey, he doesn't want this to work, so it turns it off. And also, now this is not the auxiliary switch bank, okay? That's not this. Those four little switches, that is not this. This is something else right here. This is the switch bank at the bottom, or not the bottom, the switch bank that houses the auto stop start button. So don't confuse that with the four auxiliary switches.
All right, guys, if you would like to see the complete auxiliary switch wiring diagrams, I'm going to put a poll up here in the top right corner. Just click yes or no, and if I get enough yeses, then I would be happy to show you that wiring diagram. If you like this kind of information, make sure you give me a big thumbs up. Also, I've got some really good videos coming up here in the next week or so, so make sure you hit that subscribe button with the bell, and guys, we'll see you next time. Have a great day.